Toastmasters, fellow Toastmaster, and welcome guests. Today I'm going to demonstrate to you what equipment. Before showing that, I want to assure you that it's not a rocket launcher. Okay, let us see what the equipment is. There are various pieces for it. This is the first piece. Second one. Now it's complete safely. Okay, as most of you can guess, it's a cooking vessel. And what it's used for? It is used to cook one kind of rice cake. It's a steamed rice cake maker. So the process of cooking is, first, this is a simple vessel. There is nothing inside. Just need to boil water in this, just 2/3 of it. And then this acts like a pressure cooker. It's a mini pressure cooker. And we need to use some rice powder, or it could be wheat powder, and it needs to be very coarse, and need to mix it with little bit of warm water and mix it in such a way that it will remain porous, means steam can pass through it. If it's not porous, there is an issue, problem. Okay, so we got it. And after some 5 minutes, we will get the recipe ready. And we put some coconuts in between, some little bit pieces of coconut, so that as a separator. And the name of this is a favorite dish in Kerala. It's a breakfast item. And the name of it in Kerala is called Puttu. And Puttu means partition. Partition means we are just putting coconut in between and just dividing it. And people eat it in various ways. Anyway, before going into all those things, we want to know how it really looks like. So I've got a few sheets. So inside that there are some papers which you can pass on. And it's there on everywhere. And we got a staple sheet as well. If you open it, you can see the picture. It's small. Actually, it's too small. That's why we did think of using a slide. So that is how it looks like. And people have it in various combinations. Actually, the one which is shown in the picture is made of wheat, not rice. Usually, it's made by rice, but if it's made by rice, I can't show the texture which is created by putting coconuts in between. And it's a very delicious dish which is enjoyed by people. And some people make it with putting some jackfruit in between, as well as some other fruits in between. I sometimes put a lot of this dry fruits in between, and it tastes a lot differently. And how it tastes? It tastes somewhat similar to couscous, but it's not exactly that taste. It's slightly different because of the steamed way it's prepared. And another thing, like couscous, we have it with the chickpeas as well, which is a really delicious meal. And instead of this vessel, now you can imagine there is another way to prepare it. You can just put this on the top of a pressure cooker, as a normal pressure cooker as well, And sometimes even people don't use this as well. People just put a coconut shell, the one hemisphere of it, on the top of the cooker and put the rice powder inside that. And that has got a different flavor because of the coconut shell which is used for cooking. So if you are visiting any Kerala restaurant, you can have a try of this. It's a very delicious recipe. And I'm not sure whether you can make it at home. If you can get some one coconut shell, or you can, when you buy coconut, you can just break it, and you need to use the meat first, the meat inside that, and finish it off by grating or anything. And then afterwards, you can use the shell and just put some rice powder and mix it with some rice powder. You need to mix it in a bowl, rice powder with some hot water. And then just put it on the coconut shell, and then after some time it will be cooked, it will be steamed very well. Okay, and about rocket science. An interesting incident happened to me when I came to UK for the first time. So I just bought this from home. Not this one, it's an old version. And this one has got something which fits with this side, with the bottom vessel. But normally it comes just like this, without any cooker kind of apparatus. Okay, so once I just prepared by talking to my mother all these things. So I just poured water up to the brim, and then I put it into a thick paste. The rice has become a very thick paste, and I put it inside. And after 5 minutes, just when I